folks, this is Ben. I'm here to tell you about the pan setup. I get questions every day on pans, and I've written about it in my book called Hot Dogs Saved My Life. You can find that at the website. It's kind of a course all in one, kind of a book course, and it will walk you step by step through everything you need to know. But I also like to provide on the blog at learnhotdogs.com anything you want to know about hot dogs. And I'd love it if you would submit some information, if you want me to cover something, if you want me to cook your favorite dog on the cart, if you want me to show a technique in cooking, just let me know. I'm using the big dog cart today. I've got a brand new one here, and so I've never fired this up, but today we won't need to fire it up. I do want to show you real quick the pan setup. This first pan is it's called a steam pan. All the pans are steam pans. They're not like your household cooking pans. This one is a full size, and every dimension of pan is based off of full size. So when you hear somebody say a half size, it's half of this. When you see a quarter, it's a fourth of this. And all the way down to a ninth size, really. And I think they even make a 12th size. But bottom line is this is a full size pan, and this is what we would call a spillage pan. Use on hot dog carts, we use them as a steam pan, which is what they are, and they will create the steam that will cook your foods. Now, what I'll do is this goes directly over the burners, okay? Then what happens is you will put water in this pan, roughly 2 inches of water, and that will give you enough water to heat up and start boiling, and it will steam, and that steam rises and comes through another pan. And let me show you that pan real quick. This is a half-size steam pan. If you notice, it's half the size of this full-size pan. You can put it on either side. You could have two of these. They make the steam pans, they're called perforated pans. They make these in several different ways. So some of them have, you can get a fourth size. You can get a third size. They're harder to find in the smaller denominations. You can find them in a full size, so it would fit and cover this whole area. But for the purposes of this today, I want to show you the half size, because what I do is I put my half size here to the right, and what I'll do is put my 2 inches of water in here. I'll turn my burners up high, and that is constantly steaming. And I'll throw my buns in there from time to time as I need to. So what I would be doing as I'm cooking is I would have, let's say, I'd have hot dogs in here steaming. I would have, or just leftover hot dogs, because I like to boil my dogs because they hold longer. But if you're in a rapid setup, and you've probably heard me talk about it, rapid steaming, you'd have this on super high. It'd be steaming super fast. It'd steam a frozen hot dog all the way to done, basically ready to eat, about 140 degrees center temperature of the dog, in about 7 minutes if it's on high. And what I'll do is throw the buns in there just as I need them. So I'll have a couple buns in there as my line starts building up. And then what I'll end up doing is, as I take a bun out, I'll add another bun, because the buns will get soggy quick. If you want to leave buns in this while you're cooking, you'll want to turn your steam way down so that it's barely steaming. So that's that. I want to show you what we do also as well on these is, these are 1/4 size, so they're half the size of a half size pan and 1/4 the size of a full size pan. So these are called 1/4 size pans. This is a space bar. The space bar goes between your half size pan and whatever pans you'd have next to it. You could put another half size pan or 3/9 size pans. You could do it multiple ways, but what for the purpose today, I'm going to do this. Now, what I would use these pans for is I use mine for chili, because it keeps it off the flame. There's no flame directly on this pan. It's having to hit the bottom of the big pan, the spillage pan, heat the water, and then that steam and heat heats up my chili, heats up cheese, heats up whatever you want to put in there. Sometimes I will cook up a batch of my famous caramelized Coke onions, and I will put those in here. Now what I do, and I've just started doing, is using the liners so I don't have to clean as much. It makes life easier. But you can use Pam no-stick cooking spray or anything like that and spray it, and it'll make your job easier too. But you don't have to worry about dried on, scorched on foods on here. Now, that solves all of the one side of the steam table. Now, the Big Dog has, it's a double-sized steam table. It's actually almost two full-sized steam tables. So, what we do is, when you get a Big Dog, and you don't have to do yours this way, but a lot of carts come with this size steam table. If they don't, they usually come with just this size. So if your cart just came with this size, you're still able to do a lot of different stuff with this. The Big Dog, the reason we came out with it is so you can have a variety. You can offer more things for people. This is a half size pan, same size as that perforated pan I showed you just a minute ago, but notice it doesn't have any holes in it. This goes directly over the heat. These are stainless steel pans. This would go directly over the top of the burner, and that allows it to cook faster. You'll also notice it's deeper. It's deeper than the ones that sit inside of a pan. So because it's deeper, it's sitting closer to the flame, you're allowed to put more product in it. Now what I do is put about 2 to 3 inches of water in here. Then I add my beef bouillon cubes, or I add an old can of beer, anything like that, and I super saturate the water first. Basically what I'm doing is flavoring the water so that as the dogs boil, the water doesn't sap out the flavor from the dogs. And that works well. So what I'll do is I'll boil this, get it boiling, throw in 30, 40 dogs, and in about 7 minutes from frozen, they're done. And then I just turn off the flame. So I'll turn off the flame that's under this pan and just let them sit. They'll stay at that temperature for a long time because I've still got this going and I've got another burner. And so it'll stay hot for hours and hours, but you shouldn't have dogs that long or you need to move locations. Bottom line is when you use this, what I'll do is when I start getting low, I'll transfer them over to my perforated pan, a few dogs, and then I'll start another batch. And that's how I keep up with my day. If you notice, when we send out our Big Dogs, and you don't have to use these, but they have the notched lids that helps you with your ladle, spatula, stuff like that, that you're going to use inside of their tongs. This is a third size pan. So do you remember the big full size pan that I started with? This would fit, three of these would make up that because it's 1/3 size. I haven't taken the styrofoam out of it yet, but that would fit 1/3 size. It's the deeper one, so it's not made to go in a spillage pan. You would want a 4-inch instead of a 6-inch if you were gonna do inside of a spillage pan. But a third size pan I put right here. Now, depending on what you're doing, let's say you're doing brats, or you're doing another type of dog, or you're doing a vegetarian like a tofu dog, you wouldn't want it mixed with your regular dogs. So you could boil those in here. I have even, when I've worked a cart without a grill, I've actually put a hot dog, as far as I've sprayed this down, put grease in it, turned the flame on high, and caramelized my onions right inside of there. It makes a mess, but it works. And all in all, that is it on the pan setup. Now, perforated pans are expensive. They're not horrible, but I don't know why they charge more for them, but they do. But there's a way around this, and I use them a lot of times on my cart. If I'm using a little pan and I want to steam something and I don't have a spillage pan, they make false bottoms for these, which basically is a sheet of metal with holes in it that fits right in the bottom, and it holds it off the bottom of the pan by only about a 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch. So you put a very little bit of water in it. The flame comes up and hits the pan, creates steam. Steam comes through those holes. The reason for that metal grate or that false bottom is it allows the food product not to touch your water, and it allows the steam to come through, steaming whatever you want to steam. I know some people that steam vegetables even on these. So I wanted to tell you about that. I'll eventually have some of those and I'll show them to you. The ones I have right now are filthy dirty and I didn't want to put them in the video, but this is a good way to do it. I hope you enjoyed that. Like I said, if you have any questions or you want to see something specific, I'm going to do a video or two a week giving some helpful tips, some operation guides, some techniques, and we'll show you how to do this. Something, though, I forgot to tell you real quick. When you first set up this pan, this spillage pan, and it has the water in it, you'll want to be vigilant in checking the water because it will evaporate out. That steam you see leaving is the water that you put in it. So always be mindful of your water. Check it every now and then and add some more in it. The nice part about the perforated pans is you can pour it right into here. It goes into the bottom. You don't have to pull any pans out. So touching nothing hot. It works well. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching.